Hi guys, in this video we are going to create a live dashboard in order to monitor a distance value using the sensor HCSR04 and ThingsUp and NodeMCU. For this you need a HCSR04 ultrasonic sensor, a NodeMCU ASP8266 and few jumpers. Ultrasonic sensor helps you in finding the distance of the object in front of it. And NodeMCU is the IoT board which helps you in connecting to the ThingsUp, and jumpers helps you to connect the both. Now let us see how to create a dashboard in order to monitor the distance value which is coming from the NodeMCU. So before going to it, make sure that you have a ThingsUp account signed in and make sure that you have enough credits in the billing section. Once you have enough credits, we are good to go. Now before going to start, let's create a MQTT device. So click on add device in the device management, and you need to follow the steps given in the MQTT basics video in the ThingsUp YouTube channel and create a MQTT device. So in view devices, I'm going to use this device for this video. Okay, make sure that you have the topic called distance or dist, anything of your wish, as pub and sub, so that in this topic the data will be published and the data from this topic is taken and used in the dashboard. So once it is done, click save and make sure that your device is enabled. Now let's go and create a dashboard. Click on dashboards, click on create dashboard, and you can specify any name here. So I'm giving it as distance monitor and click add. So a new dashboard is created. Now we can add any widgets to it. So I'm clicking on add here. Now let's create a data tile here. So click on data tile and click add widget. You can place it anywhere and you can also resize it depending upon your wish, and click settings to configure it. So in the name you can specify anything. I'm giving like this distance. The topic under which our data is going to get published is distance. Again, you can also change the colors, background color, the data color and the unit color. Here the unit is centimeters, so I'm giving like this, that is cms, and the key in which the data distance is present is dist, so I'm giving like this, dist. You can also specify the decimal units depending upon your data. So for me there is no decimal units, so I'm giving it as 0 and click save changes. So a data tile is created in order to show the live data that is coming in the topic. I am also creating a line chart so that all the data is plotted with the corresponding timestamp. So I am resizing like this and I am giving settings to customize it. In the name you can also specify anything. I am giving like this. The topic is same, that is distance. Here my maximum value is 300. Since ultrasonic sensor HCSR04 can sense a maximum range of up to 300 centimeters, so I am giving the maximum value as 300 centimeters and the minimum value as 0. Since this is a time series data, that is the data is going to get plotted upon the corresponding timestamp, so I am giving the type as time series, and I am going to specify the key in which the distance data is going to get published to the topic, that is DIST, and click save changes. So once it is done, click save. A distance monitor dashboard is created. You can click on the distance monitor on the left hand side so that to see your dashboard. So let's keep it aside and let's check whether this dashboard is working or not with our test value. So click on command. We are going to connect to the MQTT device and let's publish some sample data so that we can test whether the dashboard is working or not. So for that, click on view devices. Since I have already said this is the device that I am going to use, I am copying this device key and pasting it here. You need to specify the password which you have done at the time of creation and click on connect. Once the device is connected, now let's subscribe to the topic slash account ID, copy it, paste it here, slash the topic name, that is distance. Click subscribe. The distance topic is subscribed now. Okay, let's publish data to the same topic. So I'm copying this here and pasting it here. I'm creating a simple JSON string with the key as dist and the corresponding value is 250, and I'm giving a send. As you can see here, the data is sent, the topic, and also received here since we have already subscribed to it. Now let's go and check in the dashboard. As you can see, the value 250 is obtained in the data tail, and also the line chart is plotted on the corresponding timestamp. Now let us see how to connect the NodeMCU to this ThingSub through MQTT and send the values so that this dashboard gives you a live monitor of the distance data that is coming from the NodeMCU. Okay, now let us see how to connect the ultrasonic sensor, that is HCSR04, and the NodeMCU together. So for it, you need to connect the trigger pin to D6 and the echo pin to D7 as mentioned in the code. If you want to change the pins, you can also change to the corresponding pins to the corresponding pins in the code and connect the ground to the ground terminal. Okay, when it comes to VCC, the HCSR04 requires 5 volts. If you have a low lin node MCU, it doesn't have a 5 volts pin, so you need to have a separate 5 volt source in order to connect to the VCC and the ground to the node MCU. You need to have a common ground here, or else if you have Ameca node MCU board, you can connect the VCC directly to the VIN so that you'll get 5 volts for the HCSR04. Okay, now let us see how to connect NodeMCU to ThingSub and send the distance value to the ThingSub from NodeMCU. So for that, go to thingsub.io, scroll down to this footer and click on examples. And you can see the NodeMCU ultrasonic MQTT example here. Click on it and open the code. This is the Arduino code which helps in publishing the distance value in the MQTT topic. I've already downloaded the code here. Now let's see what to do with the modifications in the code. So first you need to connect to the Wi-Fi, and you need to specify the corresponding Wi-Fi SSID and the corresponding Wi-Fi password. Okay, and your trigger pin of the HCSR04 ultrasonic sensor is connected to D6, and the echo pin of the ultrasonic sensor is connected to D7. You can change it depending upon your wish. Now you need to specify these following credentials in order to connect to the MQTT server of ThingSub. You need to specify the password for MQTT device which you have created at the time of creating the MQTT device in ThingSub. So I have specified the password like this, and the username is the device name in the view devices page. So go to devices. In the view devices, you can see this device key here. So copy it, paste it in the username, and the client IDs, you can specify anything. I am giving like this. In the account ID, you need to specify this. So copy this and paste it here. This is the account ID. So once it is done, you can upload the code to the NodeMCU. You can also change the corresponding topic name to which the distance data is going to get published. So I have specified the topic as distance in ThingSub, so I'm specifying the same here. As you can see here, a JSON string is created with a dist key which gives you the distance which is calculated above. So the distance from the HCSR04 is obtained through this code. So once the centimeter value, the distance value, is obtained in this variable, I am specifying it to the dist key inside the JSON, and once it is done, I am serializing the JSON and I am sending this JSON as a payload to ThingSub. So as you can see here, in every 5 seconds this data will be published. You can change this value depending upon your time interval in order to publish the data to the MQTT topic to the ThingSub. So once it is done, connect your NodeMCU. Make sure that your port is selected, and make sure that your board is selected as NodeMCU version 1.0, and click upload. So once it is uploaded, click on the serial monitor in order to check the output. As you can see here, first it will connect it to the given Wi-Fi network. Make sure that the Wi-Fi is turned on. So once it is connected, it will show you the IP address. Now as you can see, it is connected to the MQTT server, and it will show you the distance value which is calculated using the HCSR04 sensor. And in every 5 seconds the data is published to the topic. You can see it here. So now let's go and check in the ThingSub. As you can see here, since the topic is already subscribed, the data is obtained here every 5 seconds. and the payload is like this with the key as dist and the corresponding value. Now let's go and check in the dashboard. As you can see here, the data tile gives you the live data of the distance value coming from the NodeMCU, and the line chart plots the distance value with the corresponding timestamp. So successfully, a live distance monitor is created using ThingsUp and the sensor HCSR04 using NodeMCU.